Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we're going over a really, really neat trick that you can use in your crafting, and that is going to be creating and applying QR codes. Hey guys, so let's talk about QR codes and what they can do for you, your crafting, possibly your business. So QR codes, let me show you an image of what I'm talking about. The reason that I want to show you QR codes today is because we do have some great projects coming up. So this is an introductory video to be able to show you what a QR code is, where you can get one, kind of how you're going to set it up, and then how you're going to bring it into your software. These are codes, they've been pretty popular. I actually don't remember when they first came out, but they were extremely popular when they first came out, and then they've kind of hung around the past couple years. They are really useful in my opinion. I like using them with my crafting. They're a great way to provide links without your recipient or your business customer to have to type the links in themselves. So this is a code that you can generate completely free online, and you will use a link to a website. So what that means is that I can choose any link I want, whether it's a link to a YouTube video, it's a link to my business website, maybe it's a link to an audio clip or a video that I uploaded myself. You can do that with a lot of services like Dropbox or Google Drive. And basically, once you get that link, you can create your own code like this to then apply to almost any surface. So think of it this way. You can use printable adhesive vinyl, which is what I've done in the past for a project. You can cut this out of adhesive vinyl, which is a little bit more difficult because depending on the size of the QR code, these little boxes can get lost or moved around. And of course, if the code is changed, then it's going to not work the way you intend it to. But you can also use it for heat transfer vinyl. You can use it on any type of printable. I used it on a business card. Really, there's just kind of an unlimited project library of things that you can do using a QR code. Now, what does this mean for your recipient? This means that your recipient, just like it shows here, can use their cell phone or mobile device to scan the code and instantly open your link on their device. Now, most updated phones, most recent phones, you can do this straight from the camera feature. So basically you open the camera, you don't even take a picture, you just scan it to where the camera can see the code and it will automatically ask, do you want to open this website on your phone? And you click yes. It's super easy, really, really easy. So let's go ahead and look at how to generate this code and then how to get the code from the website, from any of these websites, into use in your software. So all I did, I came here, I did a Google search for QR code generator. Like I said, these are free. I just click on the very first one up here and it's qrcodegenerator.com. Here's the address. And I'm going to grab my link and just paste it right here. So let's actually experiment. Let's see, here we go. So this is the product. This is one of the products that I like to use the QR codes with. I can simply grab the link. I use Control C on my keyboard and I can paste it here. And this is the QR code that somebody can scan and it'll take them directly to that product. So if you have a website that, like I said, this is really great to put on business cards. If you wear logoed apparel out in public or you have your logo on your car, then this is a really good option where people would be able to scan your code and go straight to your website. If you want to link to a song, you can come out here to YouTube. So I'm just going to copy. I can come over here, paste it, and let it generate, and it will create a brand new code. And of course, if I want to, I can choose different frames that are available, just depending on, you know, where I'm gonna put it. I'm just gonna grab this one. It is the most basic, and I can download as a JPEG image. Now, I can download as an SVG, but I do have to sign up for an account. Now, let's also talk about the fact that this website will allow you to upload a file, and then it will host for you whatever content that you upload. But I'll be honest with you guys, not that that's not a good service, I'm sure it is, but I like to host anything that I am giving out in an area that I can control. So I do use Google Drive and Dropbox for a lot of things, and then I can just grab a sharing code from there. So completely up to you, but know that that is an option. This website also gives you some ideas of what you can use more QR codes for. And this in particular shows a lot of marketing materials, but just something to check out. I think it's really neat. You know, I really like them a lot. I think they're very useful. I know I've been talking a lot about using this for businesses, but I do see this a lot for memorial items too. And I'll show you a project with that. So let's go ahead and download the free format. So I'm just going to download the JPEG version, and it'll tell you up here your QR code is being generated. Please do not refresh or exit. So we're just going to wait, and it will initiate a download to our computer. There we go, down here at the bottom. And then once it's done, we're going to jump over to our software and take a look. I'm just going to show you in Silhouette Studio. I'm going to go to File and Merge, and I'm going to bring that JPEG file in from my Downloads folder because I really want you to see, I don't want to say how complex, but you can definitely tell that there are a lot of small pieces here. So I do usually recommend using this as a printable, but if you decide that you do want to use this with adhesive vinyl or heat transfer vinyl, just make sure, number one, you may want to locate a website that will allow you to download it in an SVG format. That way it's nice and ready for you and you don't have to do any tracing. But also make sure that whatever project you're putting it on is going to be large enough to accommodate these smaller size cuts. So when I use it as a printable, I can just actually leave it in the format that it's in, and you'll see that I will be able to use it just as is. It's not going to try to cut out any of those little pieces that are in there. And that would be true if you're using in Cricut Design Space. So let's also take a look over there. So from Cricut Design Space, I'm just going to go to Upload and upload my image. And then from here, if I wanted to, I could erase the entire white background. Now you can see that would be a lot of clicks to get in here. So if you are gonna cut it, like I said to my Silhouette people, you do want to, there are websites out there that you can just get an SVG format. Like I said, I prefer the printable, so I'm just gonna use this one. And I'm just gonna leave it like it is. And then I can bring that in here and use it as a print and cut. And of course I can layer it with whatever project I'm using. That way I can flatten it and use them together. Now let me show you a few projects that I have done using the QR codes. Now you guys have seen this one before. I actually did a video with you guys on making these, and it's super easy. All you're going to do is import your photo and then layer your QR code on top. And these are really nice to sprinkle around the house or to give as gifts. You can choose any photo. So that's one of my boys. I do have another photo back here. This is my wedding photo. And then of course I was able to make it mimic a music player and then layer that QR code. So anytime I'm feeling sentimental, I can whip out my phone and scan the QR code and get immediate access to that song. This is what I was talking about, that it's really good for memorial items because you can overlay that QR code on top of any image to be able to print it out. So what that means is if you have a special memory with a loved one, then you can definitely, you know, find your favorite picture of them or you guys together or a family picture, and then a song that's going to remind you of some really special times. And you can recreate a product just like this on any surface. You can make it in t-shirts, you can add it to acrylic like this, you can add it to photo frames, you can put it on keychains. There's really just not a limit to what you can do because you have the QR code to be able to print it out and put it on any surface. Now this one is just an example. Like I told you, I put it on some business cards. I run a local vinyl shop and I was constantly having my customers ask, what type of heat press do I use? So this is a card that I made up to show them, hey, this is my favorite heat press. This is the one that you're using today because I allowed them to come in and use it. And then they could take that home and they could scan it at their leisure. Now you could do the same thing, like I said, with a link straight to your business. And in my opinion, like I said, just really, really useful. While they could look it up, the fact that you're adding a QR code, not only does it make a lot of people just want to scan it, I see a code, I want to scan it, I want to check it out. And then I don't have to worry about my laziness kicking in and saying, hey, I don't want to type in that website, and I just let the code do it for me. So really neat, really like them a lot. And hopefully now you understand more about QR codes and you will be better prepared because we do have some really awesome QR code project tutorials coming for you right around the corner.
So guys, how did you feel about learning about QR codes? Now, I know that not all projects require QR codes, so hopefully you will save this video for the future, or maybe just jump right into a project that does need a QR code, and you can see how the magic works for yourself. But guys, I just really appreciate you stopping by today. If you have any questions, please make sure you leave those below. I do love to hear from you guys. And of course, if you don't mind, give the video a quick like if you learned something today, maybe share with a crafty friend. All of those things and subscribing to the channel really help support us and to help us keep bringing you these videos in the future. So again, guys, I do really appreciate it. I'm going to wrap it up for today, but I will see you again next time.